Documents like quotes often get created with Microsoft Word. In this tutorial, Salesforce admins will learn how to create templates with Foxit eSign for Salesforce from a Word-based document. On the Foxit eSign setup page, select Create Foxit eSign Templates to automate your signature process. Next, click on Document from Word. Now we can choose our Word template. First, name the template and add a template description. Click on Upload Document to open the file browser. Choose the Word document you'd like to use as a template. As a data source, we will use Quote. In the next step, we can merge our fields. On our Word-based template, we have single-row data mapping and multi-row data mapping. In this Word document, you can see the tags that were added. The ones with a single curly bracket are single-row data tags. And multi-row data mapping is defined with two curly brackets. When pulling Salesforce data, it will be added where the tags are. Even if you have multiple line items, the table will automatically and dynamically get generated. So if we need to add more rows to this document, we can without disrupting the document's formatting. Let's map our fields. To map a field, click on the drop-down menu for Select Foxit eSign Template field and select the first field. Let's start with Quantity. Then select the corresponding Salesforce fields. In this case, it's Quote Line Items child first, and then we select Quantity. Now we have mapped our first field. To add more, click Add Row and repeat the process for the other fields. Once you're done merging your fields, click Next. Now we can create a custom button to add it to our quote page layout. I will keep Generate via Foxit eSign. Check the box next to Quote Layout. Finally, click Save and Close. Now the quote template will show up in our Foxit eSign template list. To show you the Generate via Foxit eSign button, I will open up a quote. Click on the app launcher, type in quotes, and choose it. Select a quote. You'll find the Generate via Foxit eSign button on the top right. After we click on it, we can choose our quote template and submit it. Under Notes and Attachments, you can find the customized quote we just generated. Let's click on the PDF to take a look. As you can see, our fields were added. To ensure end users can send a quote for signature in only a few seconds, we should add a Send via Foxit eSign button to our quote page layout. So let's go back to the Foxit eSign Setup tab and choose Include an eSignature button in any layout with more flexibility. Next, we'll add Quote as the data source. Click Next. I want to keep Send via Foxit eSign as the button name, but again, you can customize the name. Make sure to check Quote under Page Layout, and finally click Save and Close. Now, let's go back to our quote. And as you can see, the Send via Foxit eSign button has been added in the top right corner. Select the button. Remember, we have just generated the quote. So the next step is to select Document from a Salesforce record. That way, you can send out files attached to Salesforce records. Let's choose the quote we just generated. Click Next. Now we're in the Foxit eSign sending flow. Choose the recipient. Click Save and Next. We can add additional fields to the document if we want to. I will add a signature field by simply dragging and dropping it onto the document. After clicking Send, you can choose and customize your email template. Once done, click Send to send the quote for e-signature. And now it's your turn. Start creating Word-based templates to help your organization close deals faster.